This conference will now be recorded.
Thank you.
Yes.
So, today's concept name is test development. Test development. So in the test development, first we will discuss use case concept. Use case. What do you mean by use case? Use case is nothing but just like, so use case document prepared by business analyst. Actually, business analyst, he will prepare the use case document based on the customer requirements. Based on the customer requirements only, he will prepare the use case document. Business analyst, he will prepare the use case document. So this use case document is very helpful for testing engineer. Why? Because so if it is fresher or experienced person, after getting job or after going to software company, each and every software company people, the people, they will give you use case document and FRS also. FRS and use case document also. After getting use case document, we can understand the requirements very clearly. Without use case document, we can't understand the requirements very clearly. So this business analyst, he will prepare based on the customer requirements, he will prepare the use case document. What is use case document? I will tell you now. For example, I'm taking one calculator application. For example, calculator application means add button should work fine. This is the customer requirement. Add button should work fine. This is the customer requirement. Add button. So already number of times already I show you one calculator application. Once again I will show you, but add button should work fine. This is the customer requirement. So based on this requirement, customer business analyst will write, if you take 10 in the place of value 1, if you take 20 in the place of value 2, if you click an add button, result must be 30. So customer is said only one requirement, so add button should work fine. But business analyst, based on the requirement, he will write use case. So if you take 10 in the place of value 1, if you take 20 in the place of value 2, if you click an add button, result must be 30, he will write. So then then we can take 10 in the place of value 1 and we can take 20 in the place of value 2. If I click an add button, 30 is coming or not, I can do it. So it's very easy. So work will be very easy. So that means, so based on the customer requirement only, business analyst, he will write the use case. Using this use case, we can do our work easy. Okay, simply we can say, so use case is nothing but one actor is doing some action . What is the response coming? Everything everything he will show, he will tell. Actor, action and response. So what is use case? Use case is nothing but, so you can understand, just actually customer, he will give the requirement, sir. So based on the requirements, we need to write the use cases. So use cases document prepared by business analyst, sir. This is not our task, sir. Today also this is not our task, but we can understand the requirements. So here actor means something. Actor is doing some action. What is the response coming? Everything it will show in use case. Already I told you, customer, he said add button should work fine. That is the customer requirement. Based on the requirement, business analyst, if you take 10 in the place of value 1, if you take 20 in the place of value 2, if you click on add button, result must be 30. So he shown everything. Okay, easy. Now I can take 10 in the place of value 1, I can take 20 in the place of value 2. If I click on add button, 30 is coming or not, I can check it. So it's very easy. Work will be very easy. That is the use case document, right? So actor, if he do some action, what is the response coming? Everything it will show you in use case. Or next, it will describe the all the functionalities in the application. It will describe the all the functionalities in the application. What is use case? Use case is nothing but it will describe the all the functionalities in the application. So it will teach you. So everything, every application, every button, every functionality in the application. So that's the reason we can say it is a use case. What do you mean by use case? It will describe the all the functionalities in the application. So each and every application information, so each and every functionality information, each and every application information, so everything it will show you. So functionality means some of the part in the application, but every application means total application information. Everything it will show you. So that's why we can say it is a use case. Today concept is use case document. Use case document prepared by actually business analyst, not me and not you. Use case. Today concept name is test development. So use case document business analyst will prepare. Okay, based on the use case document only we can work. Wherever you go, if it is any software company, after getting software job, software testing job, that business analyst and customer, you will give FRS document. Only if you get only FRS document, we can't understand the requirements very clearly. After getting use case document only, we can understand the requirements very clearly. Like what we need to do. So already I told you, add button should work fine. That is the customer requirement. The customer simply he said, so add button should work fine. So how? Add button should work fine. So but business analyst too, he will write use case. If you take 10 in the place of value 1, if you take 20 in the place of value 2, if you click on add button, result must be 30. So then easily, so we will take 10 in the place of value 1, we will take 20 in the place of value 2. So if I click add button, 30 is coming or not? So it's very easy work. Okay, we can understand the requirement very clearly. Wherever you go, if it is software company, they will give FRS document as well as use case document also. After getting use case document only, we can understand the requirements very clearly, sir. Okay, what is use case? Use case is nothing but just like it will show you everything, like if it is any actor, if they do any action, what is the response coming, everything you can say. So that is use case. Or we can say simply, it will describe the all the functionalities in the application. Okay, right. Today concept is use case. I will explain you. So customer requirement, I will show you. Just wait 1 second. Where is the application? Go to Dodo. Sir, this is the application you want, sir. You want this type of application. Okay. Now tell me requirements. Already I told you in the first class, first day already I told you. If you want to take the requirements, if you want to give the requirements, it's not very easy. So there is a reason you should know. You should know, compulsory you should know. So now tell me, you want this type of application. This application you want, sir. Just to tell me your requirements. So based on your requirements, I will prepare this application. Ask, tell me first.
For this kind of application, I need username, password, connect, cancel, and clear. But they added one option, connect to, I don't know why. So main,
you want this application, sir. So you are the customer, sir. So you want this application. I am the developer or software company owner, whatever it is. So you want this type of application. Already I am showing application, also I am showing. So you should tell your requirements very clearly. Based on your requirements only I can develop this application. So you should tell very clearly what you want, what is your expectations. Compulsory I should know, then only I can do, I can develop this application. So please take your time, own time, but you should tell clearly. So based on your requirements I can develop the application, but clearly you should tell. Why? Because I am the developer. Okay, you have some expectations. So what is that? I don't know. Okay, so how can I develop this application? So you should tell very clearly, sir, I need some application. So clearly you should tell, then only I can develop the application.
Yes, sir. So
take your own time, but tell me clearly.
We want username.
Based on your requirements only, I can develop that application. Okay.
Yeah.
Why should I know?
Because you need to develop the application very clearly according to my requirements.
Ah, yes.
So for example, we want username, sir. When typing username, clear button should appear. And we want password. After password, we need to highlight the correct button and we need to show some drop down box. In that we'll use several options. After doing all this, sign in button should appear and cancel should appear from starting itself in order to end the application.
Okay, no problem, sir, no problem. But I will tell you. So requirement giving and taking, it's not very easy. Already I told you in the first class only, already I told you. So business analyst, he will doing only same task. Okay, he will fully interact with the customer. Sir, what you want, what is your expectations? You said only 3 points, only within 1 minute you completed, but you want this type of application. So this application you want, not this type. So you want this application. So you said only 3 points, just like I need username, sir, password, sir, connect to field, sir, cancel button, sir, you said. Okay. Only using that information, how I can develop this application? It is impossible. So already there's a reason already told you in the first class only. So requirement giving and taking, it's not very easy. So there's a reason a business analyst, he will fully interact with the customer. Different customers, they have different expectations. So we need to reach that expectations. Why? Because we are from software company. So what is expectations? So business analyst you will totally gather the requirements. Okay, right, I will teach you now. Okay, now today concept is, okay, first of all we need to understand the requirements. How we can understand the requirements, we will discuss. So you want this type of application, how customer is giving requirements, I will explain. Okay, you want this type of application, so customer is giving requirements. So if you want to prepare use case document, business analyst, you will prepare the use case document. This is also not our task. So test plan prepared by test lead will prepare the test plan document. If we want to prepare the use case document, we need four things means 4 points. One is screenshot, application screenshot. Okay, screenshot already available. Okay, well if you have a screenshot, not enough, so compulsory we should have FRS means customer requirements. Okay, after that, after giving the FRS document, business analyst will add extra points, that is called special requirements. For example I will tell you, special requirements. What is special requirements? I will tell you. So for example, I am the person, sir. I need one website, sir. I will go to one designer place, sir. So he will ask you, sir, what type of website you want, sir? I have one training center, sir. I need one website, sir. Website should be good. Okay, I will tell requirements. After telling the requirements, that designer, he will add extra points. Sir, still you are in 1947, sir. So right now number of people, they are choosing websites like this, sir. I'm totally new to that area, I don't know anything. So he will guide, sir. Still you are in 1947, sir. Right now number of people, they are choosing websites like this way. Okay, he will give some suggestions. Why? Because I am totally new to that area, but he knows very well. Why? Because daily he is doing same work, so he knows very well. So he will add extra points. So that is called special requirements. Special requirements given by business analyst to BA.
Yes.
And fourth point, screenshot, FRS, special requirements, and use case template. Sir, this is not also our task, sir. So use case template prepared by business analyst, sir, not our task, sir. So test plan prepared by test lead, sir. Use case document prepared by business analyst, sir. This is also not our task, but how we can understand the requirements, today we will concentrate, sir. Okay, so if you want, if you want, for example, if you are the tester, if you want to prepare the use case document, we need four things, sir. One is screenshot. Screenshot means application screenshot, sir. This is a screenshot already shown you. So this is a screenshot. You want this type of application. So this is the screenshot. Okay. Second, FRS. FRS means customer requirements. Third, special requirements, business analyst. So after telling the customer requirements, he has some experience. So that is the reason he will add some extra points. So that is called special requirements, sir. And use case template. Okay. How it will be, I will tell you. Okay. Right. Customer is saying, first, already we have screenshot. Okay. Second point, FRS document. Customer is giving requirements only for this application only. So he is giving requirements. Concentrate. Yes, first requirement he is saying. Right, first requirement, FRS. No. You should write FRS. First requirement is saying, whenever invoke the login screen, whenever invoke the login screen, comma, login page should contain application name is login. Okay. Whenever you invoke the login screen, login page should contain username, comma, password, comma, connect to fields. So clearly he is mentioning, see. So whenever you invoke the login screen should contain username, password, connected to fields. Fields means edit boxes. Okay, fields and comma, cancel, comma, login, comma, clear buttons. Clear buttons. So he is explaining everything. He is saying, okay, whenever invoke the login screen should contain username, password, connect to fields, type of fields also he is mentioning, and at the same time, login, clear, cancel buttons also. That is the first requirement. Second point, he is mentioning. Customer is giving FRS document. FRS document given by customer. Okay. So we can say it is this point also very, very important. We can say explicit requirements given by customer. Explicit requirements. So given by customer, he is giving requirements. So we can say it is a explicit requirements given by customer. So FRS are explicit requirements. Second point, connect to is not a mandatory field. Connect to is not a mandatory field. If you want, you can use it, but connect to is not a mandatory field. If you want to fill the information, you can use it, otherwise leave it. My name is Akhil, password is something Akhil. Okay, connect to, if you want fill or if you want to leave it, okay, it will work. So connect to is not a mandatory field. Okay, username password compulsory, but connect to is not a mandatory field. Whenever user requires whenever user requires, you can select a desired database option. You can select a desired database option. Database option, that means, so already option OPTI. Okay, that means, so connected to field containing some fields like databases, like for example, if it is software company, we have different people, admin people, HR people, developers, testers. So we have different departments. So connected to is just like it is a database option. Okay, we have number of fields, which one you want, you can select, otherwise you can leave it. So connected to is not a mandatory field. If you want, you can select, otherwise you can leave it. So connected to is not a mandatory field whenever user requires. So if you want select, you can select, otherwise you can leave it. So that is the point, second point. Next, third point. Why you came? Okay, now roll. Third point. After entering, third point, after entering, entering, after entering, username, comma, password. I will ask you question, sir. Just concentrate. Okay, each and every point, each and every word is very, very important. Concentrate, and I am writing everything. I am writing. Okay, I am explaining also. So after I will ask you questions also. You should tell. Okay, concentrate. Each and every word also very, very important. Already I told you. Customer requirements, if you want to understand the customer requirements, it's not very easy. At the same time, this is the requirements customer is giving. He want this type of application, he is giving some requirements. So first of all, we should know what is he is asking. Okay, that's the reason. So read every line, read every line, every point, every word also. Okay, after entering username and password, if you click on login button, corresponding page must be open. Okay, what is corresponding page? Corresponding page must be open. After entering username and password, if you click on login button, corresponding page must be open. Okay,
the page for which mark is required.
Corresponding page means there are two types of applications, sir. There are two types of users, sir. One is normal user, sir. One is normal user. Second one is admin user. There are two types of users, sir. One is normal user, second one is admin user. Normal user, for example, we have Gmail ID, so we are the normal user, sir. If you enter username and password, it will open into your mail. That means you are the normal user, so you can get home page. Okay, if it is admin user, if you enter username and password, it will go to admin page. Okay, this is the point. So there are two types of users. If it is any application, there are two types of users. One is normal user, second one is admin user. So right now, after entering username and password, if we click on login button, corresponding page must be open. I wrote here. So corresponding page, I didn't mention. If it is normal or admin, I didn't mention. So if it is normal user, it will go to home page. If it is admin user, it will go to admin page. Okay, I mentioned clearly. So requirements, it's not very easy. So we need to mention each and every point, and each and every word also very, very important. Why? Because this is not a joke. Like, you know, based on the customer requirements, we need to develop the application. So if it is developer or developers only, they will develop the application. But each and every point also very, very important. If it is spell mistake, also, it will make you very bad name for the company. So word, concentrate. Okay, fourth point. After click on clear button. Fourth point.
After click on concentrate,
I will ask you questions. So read the requirements very clearly. I am writing slowly, so I am not very hurry. So after click on clear button, all the information must be clear. And cursor should be placed in username field. After click on clear button, all the information must be cleared and cursor should be placed in username field. Okay. Fifth point. After click on cancel button, application must be closed. These requirements given by customer. Customer is giving five requirements, sir. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. He gave some requirements. After giving the requirements, business analyst. He will add some requirements. So that is called special requirements. Or we can say another name, special requirements or implicit requirements. Explicitly First one is explicitly, second one is implicitly. Implicitly requirements. They will add some extra requirements. So customer is, you don't know. So you will add some requirements. So only effectiveness, only for effectiveness or user friendly. So there is a reason he will add extra requirements. Why? Because he knows something better than customer. Why? Because he is working every day, he is doing same work. So he knows better than us. So he will add extra extra requirements. Business analyst is one of the experienced persons and he knows something better than us. So I am the customer. So I don't know anything. I totally knew. How should I know? So I'm not professional. I'm the only one of the customer. How he knows? So there is a reason. Business analyst, he will add some requirements. Sir, you said 5 requirements, sir, but these 5 requirements not enough. So I will add some requirements. So he will add some requirements. So what are the requirements he is adding? Now concentrate. First requirement. Whenever, concentrate, read the requirement very clearly. I will ask you questions. Please concentrate. Okay. Whenever invoke the application, whenever invoke the application, login, comma, clear, login, comma, clear, must be disabled. Why he is saying? Tell me. Reason, tell me. Kanisam, just you should tell. Whenever invoke the login application, whenever invoke the application, login clear must be disabled. Why he is saying?
Because
already invoke the application. Already application is invoked. Login and clear must login and clear disabled. Observe carefully. Application also good. Application, yeah. Also you can observe. Login and clear must be disabled. Customer is saying actual application also login and clear are both are disabled. Why he is saying? What is the reason?
Yeah, because it should enable only when we enter values. Otherwise, people open the application and press login without entering values.
Customer, why he is mentioning, sir, clearly? Whenever invoke the application, login and clear must be disabled. Business analyst is adding extra requirement. So why he is saying?
Because we need to enter the username and password, then only it should appear. Otherwise, people will think, okay, we need to press login and then press login directly without entering username and password.
Yes. Thank you. And okay. Right. Okay. Without entering any information into username and password, if it is login and clear, if it is enabled or disabled, there is no use. So that's the reason he is saying after entering username and password, then it will be enabled. Okay. So right now, without entering any information into username and password, if it is enabled or disabled, there is no use. So that is the reason he is saying. Next point, cancel always enabled. Why is saying? Now tell. Cancel always enabled.
Because if you want to close the application, we need something, right? That's why it is canceled.
Yes. At any point of time, we can close the application. So for example, I am the user. So I want to work with some application. I've opened. So, but after opening the application, I don't have good mood and I don't want to work with this application. So, my mood is not good. Okay. I want close application. At any point of time, he can close the application. That is the reason. Cancel always enabled. Okay. I don't want good mood. I don't have good mood.
Yeah.
Okay. I want to close that application. At any point of time, cancel always enabled. Right. Third point. After entering username, comma, password, then only login must be enabled. Login must be enabled. After entering password, username and password, after entering username, password, then only login must be enabled. Okay. Fourth point. After entering any information into any of the field, after entering any information into any of the field, clear must be enabled. Concentrate. I will ask you questions.
Yes, sir.
Okay. After entering any information into any of the field, so clear must be enabled. After entering any information into any of the field, clear must be enabled. Fifth point. The tabbing order must be tabbing order. Must be username, comma, password, comma, connect to comma, next login, connect to username, password, connect to login, comma, clear, comma, cancel buttons. This requirements given by business analyst. He is adding requirements. 5 extra requirements he is adding. He added. So, whenever they invoke the application, login clear must be disabled. Cancel always enabled. After entering username and password, then only login must be enabled. Fourth point, after entering any information into any of the field, clear must be enabled. Fifth point, the tabbing order must be username, password, connect to login, clear, cancel buttons. He added some requirements. Okay. We have a screenshot, FRS, special requirements. Fourth point, we need use case template.
Okay.
We need use case template. Use case template. I will ask you questions, so concentrate. Each and every word, concentrate. I will ask you questions. Already I told you. Just okay. Use case template. Use case template. Business analyst only he will prepare. Name of the use case. Name of the use case. We can say login use case. Name of the use case means, so we have application name is, for example, login, login use case, login.
Yeah.
Okay, second point, brief. Description of use case.
Brief spelling wrong.
Sorry. What none? Brief. Brief description of use case. It will describe the all the functionalities in the application. It will
describe all.
Describe the. It will describe the. All the functionalities in the application, all the functionalities in the application. It will describe the all the functionalities in the application. Okay, what is use case? Already I told you, it will describe the all the functionalities in the application. So that is the reason we can say it is a use case. Actors. Actors means users. So how many users?
Only one.
No. Already I told you.
Yeah, multiple.
Actors means users, sir. How many users? I mentioned also. In the requirement, I mentioned.
Yeah. Normal admin.
There are two types of users. Two types.
Yeah.
One is normal, and other one is admin. One is normal. Second one is admin. Wherever you go, if it is any application, there are two types of users. One is normal user, second one is admin user. Third one, requirements. There are two types of requirements. What are those?
After entering username and password.
Explicit requirement, explicit implicit. One is explicit, second one is implicit. Preconditions. After entering username and password, if it is normal user, it will open home page. If it is admin user, it will open admin page. So yeah, that is precondition.
Yeah.
Post conditions. This word is not important, but leave it. Post conditions. Post conditions means if you enter wrong username, wrong password, automatically it will show you error message.
Error, yeah.
So preconditions, if you enter username, password, if it is normal user, it will enter into home page. If it is admin user, it will enter into admin page. So that is pre-conditions. Post-conditions, if you give wrong username, wrong password, if it is admin or whatever it is, if you give wrong username, wrong password, it will enter into error message. Okay. Next, flow of events. Flow of events. Now you can start flow of events. Okay. Flow of events. Action is doing actor. Okay. Response. Now I will ask you action. You should tell the response. Okay. Concentrate. Read the requirement 1 minute. Read the all the requirements 1 minute. So next, action, response, both. Action I will ask you, you should tell the response.
Okay.
Oh God.
Is that a
right?
Yeah.
Okay. Actor, click on clear button.
Yeah.
Actor means user, sir. Just like, so we are using word is actor. So user, click on clear button, or actor, click on clear button. What will happen?
Everything should get cleared. Like all the information must go.
No, sir. I mentioned.
Oh, yeah. After click on clear button, all the information must be clear, and the cursor should be placed in username field.
Yes, that point also I mentioned very clearly. I wrote here. Okay, after click on clear button, all the fields must be cleared, and cursor should be placed in username field. I wrote to. Okay. Okay. Actor enter. Actor means user only. Okay, please. Okay, in this concept always we will use just like so we will treat as a actor. Okay, actor enter username and password. If you click on login button,
the corresponding page must be open.
Corresponding page must be open, sir. If you select admin, it's admin corresponding page should open. If you select normal
corresponding page should be.
That point very, very important. I mentioned very clearly. Corresponding page must be opened. If it is normal user, home page. If it is admin user, admin page. So, yes. But you should tell corresponding page only. Okay. I mentioned very clearly. Corresponding page. So based on the user type, if it is normal user, home page, if it is admin user, admin page must be open. Okay, right. Thank you. Third, actor enter right username, right password. Right username, right password. If you click on login button, what will happen?
It should ask which correct normal admin username.
No. I mentioned only one word. Actor enter right username, right password. If you click on login button,
corresponding page should be open.
Yes, corresponding page must be open. Okay. Actor enter right username, wrong password. If you click on login button,
error message
must be displayed. Yeah. Okay. Actor enter some information into username field. If you click on clear button,
all the information must be clear and the cursor should be in the username field.
Right. Okay. Shabash. Okay, next. Okay. Actor enter right username, wrong password. If you click on clear button, what will happen?
Clear button, all the information must be clear and cursor should be placed in username.
Actor enter right username, wrong password. If you click on cancel button, something. Application must be closed.
Yeah.
Okay. Actor enter wrong username, wrong password. If you click on login button.
Error message.
Okay, Shabash. Okay, next. Actor enter only username. Actor enter only username. So he enter some username. Okay. If he click on, if he want check enable property of login button. Okay, he entered only username, he is checking. So login button is enabled or not?
Yes, sir. After any information into the any field, clear master must be enabled. Login button must not be enabled, sir. It should show enter password.
Like when we only enter username, it login button won't be enabled until unless the password is also entered.
That time you should tell. So after entering both fields like username and password, then only login button must be enabled. Why? Because already mentioned very clearly. After entering both information, then only login button must be enabled. Clear? So next. Next, I entered only single character in username. Clear button must be enabled or disabled?
Enabled.
Yes. After entering any information into any of the field, clear button must be
enabled.
After entering any information into any of the field, if it is right, wrong, whatever it is, leave it. So after entering any information into any of the field, clear button must be enabled. And next, the tabbing order must be username, password, connect to, login, clear, cancel buttons.
Yeah.
Okay. See.
Yeah.
I will show you application now. I am entering some one. Clear enabled. Observe carefully. I am entering password also 2. Login enable. Observe carefully.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cancel. If you click on cancel, application must be closed.
Yeah.
That is the concept. So how we can understand the requirements?